I moved to Southern California. This is first time or second time. And now I am very glad. New modern medical research is, scientific research is, everything shows macrobiotics is right. Food is most important. And still, scientific research cannot understand completely what kind of food is good, what kind of food is bad. But one step, more and more becoming clear. So, long time, macrobiotic people discussed very strange things. Mainly eat grains and a little vegetables, and don't eat sugar. And if once get disease, high fever is good, pain is good. Everything strange. But now, modern science proved this is also right. So, modern medicine itself changing so much. Big revolution. So, now I read many new medical books and understood. Seems everything new, need new understanding. So this time I talk mainly about such kind of subject. In the beginning, we need to understand. Of course, everybody wants a peaceful world. Peace is good. War is bad. Battle is bad. But unfortunately, our world is always a battlefield, never peaceful. This is a little strange. Why? The reason is we have to eat. If we eat, almost eat living things. So this is one kind of contradiction, but this is true. We cannot change this. Actually, what do you eat? Vegetable or grains or meat or whatever. If we eat, that's all living things. And all kind of living things, creatures, want to multiply. Also a little strange. Why everything want to multiply? Probably in the beginning of Holy Bible, God said, be fruitful, multiply, and fill up this earth. He said to all kind of creatures, not only human. So everything in nature wanted to increase. Without purpose or with purpose, not important. Everything wants to increase. So, since the very beginning of this world, always our ancestors needed to fight. So, ancient people, they recognized only large animals for enemies. So fight against large animals like lions or wolves or such kind of war battles was the main problem. But human became stronger, stronger, and made better weapon. Then, no more problem with large predators. Then, small animals attack, like mosquitoes, fleas, bedbugs, ticks, or such things. So probably this became an enemy. If mosquito bite, then someone get disease. Probably mosquito cause. of course misunderstanding, but probably this next problem. But they invented mosquito net or some kind of incense or herbs to prevent insects. Also this almost this problem is resolved. And recently made insecticide, DDT or BHC or some many kind of chemical. So this also does not bother us so much. The last 100 years, new discovery, new understanding. Our body itself battlefield. Inside our body, many bacteria or amoebas, such kind of tiny living things invade and attack our body. So, our body itself a battlefield. Enemy became smaller, smaller. And since microscope invented, bacteria attack. Only 100 years ago, this discovery, probably you know. That time, still not many microbes. Probably only medical school had one or two sets of microscope. But student never look through this lens. Only professors used for research. But since bacteria cause disease, this modern science understood me. This research developed so fast. Many kind of bacteria which cause diseases now understood. And once antibiotics was invented, many people, or even doctors, scientists, almost everybody believed. Probably we conquered all kind of infectious diseases, which microbes cause. But here was also some misunderstanding. Even bacteria disease again becoming difficult. And the more difficult problem is enemies became smaller, smaller. New discovery show virus cause diseases. Virus is so tiny. Even bacteria we cannot see with naked eyes. But viruses are much smaller. Probably 110 or more. So light microscope we cannot see. Only electron microscope developed. It can magnify 200,000 times to 1 million times. We can see. But if 1 million times magnified, it's so difficult to find, actually. Ride on airplane and fly sky of Vancouver and find out where is my car or where is my house, maybe more difficult. So this is still research developing. How many virus discovered, how many kind cause human diseases, and even smaller one comes out or not, etc. Unknown. also one next another, so many new diseases coming and almost incurable. So something is wrong. We need a completely different approach, probably. See? If we can understand food, see? Food and diseases, how related, probably this is much easier than modern scientific research. So, see? Our world is a battlefield. And our body has a defense system. Attacking enemies bacteria protozoas viruses virus protozoa similar. But this is probably a little larger. Still single cell. And include amoeba. Amoeba, this name is more common, probably. And bacteria can multiply itself, clone. But protozoa, this is some kind of sexual relationship. No clear sex, but to exchange material and multiply. So this is a little different. Other things are almost similar. See? How our body protects. That's a problem. See? We think in the past what kind of diseases we had. So many difficult diseases. Plagues, epidemics, and other diseases always attacked our ancestors. That everybody know. Maybe most feared disease will be leprosy. Since ancient time, in the many literatures, Holy Bible or other books, leprosy is written. But not only leprosy. Black death, cholera, typhoid fever, malaria. So many diseases always repeatedly attacked our ancestors. Probably heaviest attack was 14th century in Europe. Black death suddenly spread and almost entire countries in Europe, probably 1/3 or 1/4 of population died. Many towns, almost 90%. Some town completely died. Of course, rural area a little safer. Scholars guess probably 25 million people died. This is a strong bacteria. Attack human body quickly. From 2 days to 2 weeks. Incubation period also short. Once invade, then soon spread whole body. And only few people recovered, but almost died. But check our history very carefully. Strange. Some place people safe. For example, many largest area is modern Poland. Only Poland, this disease passed through. 1348, southern Europe, Italy, Spain, southern France. Then, 49, France, German, England, and went up north. And pass through Poland and 51 Russia. Or also some cities safe. For example, Milano in Italy. Or small part of southern France. No black death. Almost. Also very strange. Many prisons were safe. Prisoners kept in the prison, that's of course. They were almost safe, who were isolated. So, check this disease, where I come from, that's also interesting, but I don't know, this time I have enough time or not. Probably disease came from China. Black death probably always started from China. That happened again in 20th century. This century, early 20th century. Chinese moved to the northeast and hunt one kind of rodent. This fur expensive, like mink, expensive fur, so they hunt. They also they ate this meat. Then, about this animal, Mongolian had traditionally taboo. Don't eat this animal. Also, even if eat, then don't eat lymph nodes. That's a difficult one. So, almost Mongolian did not eat. They hunt, just take fur and throw away. But the Chinese had no such taboo. They ate. Then, disease started, black death again. to to Hong Kong, Southern China more damage. And from Hong Kong, one of European trading center on the boat, disease spread all over the world. And probably killed 100 million people. This research was done by modern scientific and medical research. So this record is perfectly clear.
The recording of pardon? That many people dying?
Pardon?
Did you say that that many people dying was
died.
Recorded by science?
Yeah, yeah. Medical research proved this is true.
You don't think they're just saying that so they can make people scared?
No. You wonder about this research?
The research?
Yeah.
When it gets to be...
This after medical science developed, so doctors always watched and made clear what kind of disease, how transmitted. In the beginning, they understood. Bacteria, this originally rodent had. But human ate. Then they got this disease. Then again, flea bite. And spread other rodent. And from other rodent, again flea bite human, then again transmitted. So this became clear. This is one kind of blood disease. From blood to blood. But here is a strange thing. If we read Decameron, Giovanni Boccaccio wrote Decameron, famous funny stories. Then he wrote, just visit, disease transmitted, or touch clothes for a patient, then also infected. That's strange. From modern scientific research proved, if fleas bite and have bacteria, then also human can get it. And fleas bite other rodent, then sick people and other healthy people again can transmit. Or if again bite rodent, then this rodent again get the disease. But why just visit and get the disease? And touch clothes, disease was transmitted. That's true or not? But this also later proved. This is true. Ancient people observed. We have two kind of diseases. Modern research proved one kind of bacteria, but can cause two kind of different looking diseases. So, Boccaccio wrote, Eastern people get mainly nose bleeding and died. And the European got almost swollen lymph node. lymph node, groin, armpit, or neck sometimes became apple size. And quickly died. So, then, here clearly he wrote two kinds of diseases, but also he thought same disease. Then, why nose bleed? This is something like tuberculosis. So modern medicine called this pestis tuberculoid. Attack lung and respiratory system and make bleeding. That comes out from nose. So respiratory system disease. Another kind is pus forming. Lymph node swell up big and make pus. That's a good sign. Still our body fighting. And if this breaks and the pus comes out, then almost patient recovered. But before pus comes out, many people died. Also, sometimes doctors made a mistake. Cut this swollen lymph node. Then, suddenly, came to the end. Then, here is one. If we eat some kind of animals, then dangerous. So, for example, now AIDS problem. New researchers say probably disease came from African green monkeys. Of course, not yet proved, but possible. Then, African people ate monkeys and got this virus. That's a possibility. But British famous doctor, AIDS researcher John Searle. John Searle. His opinion is someone eat sheep, scrapies. This is sheep disease. Now spreading to other animals, cows or dogs, of course goat. But originally this was sheep disease. Sheep's skin is itchy. They scrape their body against anything. Then hair falls down. Then nervous system, something wrong. Walking becomes strange and the body paralyzed and die. No cure. Nothing worked. Drugs, vaccination, everything failed. and the virus was discovered. Then, very, very small virus and slow. So called lentivirus or slow virus. So his opinion, someone ate sheep and got this disease. Also not yet proved, but possible. Also many other diseases, cholera, malaria. Malaria is the biggest enemy for human. Probably in our history, killed most people, that's probably malaria. This is very old and always still problem is not resolved. Even United States, every year more than 1,000 people die. Still good, much became better, but still like this. Go to tropical country, still this is prevalent. Almost seems impossible to eradicate. Another example is early this century, 1918. Flu, influenza spread all over the world, about 700 million people got the disease. Probably 23 million people died. That's not far, just recently. Before I was born, only 2 years before I was born. Flu and pneumonia. Flu attacked first and weakened the immune system. Then pneumonia attacked. So problem became a disaster. Only within less than 2 years, so many people died. Here I wrote. Some kind of diseases, this I checked. First record in Europe. For European record is more clear. Other countries has not so clear record of diseases. Of course, something written, so a little I added. So here, when diseases appeared, so I made a chart. So. If we read the history of diseases, then So many people died. We feel a little strange. Me? Why not everybody died? If so many plagues attack repeatedly, then seems population decrease, and quickly all human eradicated. But this did not happen. Also, human always increased. Now, some 5 billion people or something living on this world. Of course, so many people died, don't need to say. But our ancestors did not, never. Our body is protected perfectly in normal condition. We call healthy. Probably, new research say, every day, about 4 times, we receive microbe attack. I don't know, you don't know. But every day, about 4 times, microbe invade to our body and try to take nutrition and increase. Maybe they don't want to kill our body, but destroy our body, then someone die. If every day four times, then 1 year about 1,400 times. 70 years whole life, probably 100,000 times. So many bacteria attack. But still we are healthy. This battle, we should never lose. If once lose this war battle, that's the end. Each battle is life or death, only 2 ways. But we never died. Our ancestors never failed, always won. Even brothers, sisters, cousins, so many died, but our ancestors strongest. Strongest of strongest, champion of champion. That's our body. So still we are living. We have perfect defense system. So, in wide meaning, this is called immune system. But often immune system used for more narrower meaning. So, for example, our skin is protected completely to prevent diseases, bacteria, virus invasions. Our skin produces special material, poison for bacteria. For example, soul is one kind of this material. At least, soul comes out with sweat, evaporate this salty, that's normal. Bacteria, virus cannot multiply. Also, new research said, our body produces one kind of antibiotics material. And this excrete on the skin, already here protected. If not, always millions of bacteria touch. Just do nothing from air or anything we touch. But we are safe. See? Skin is a strong barrier. It's almost perfectly covered and difficult to invade for microbes. But if injury or insect bites, then that's possible. Also, mucous membrane. Mouth, nose, eyes. This is a more dangerous place. So our body has more protection. Saliva, tears, everything has poison for microbes. And also, tonsils, adenoid, this before doctors thought needless, so often removed, but a new discovery, this is very important immune system, to check front gate, many things comes into our body. So here, check. If virus, bacteria mixed, here, hold. And sometimes inflamed, infected. But this is good. Stopped bad bacteria invasion. So, now no more remove, except very special case. That's good. The stomach also protected by hydrochloric acid to kill bacteria. So, food go to intestine, almost safe. But if skin cut or something, bacteria invade, under skin, also our body has antibiotic-like material and try to kill bacteria. Also, if once go into bloodstream, white blood cells, white blood cells always patrolling in our body. This is a very unique cell. We know our body is made of cells, but other cells can cannot move freely, just stay. And build up tissues, organs, muscles. But the white cell can move everywhere. Even blood vessel wall, they can penetrate and can pass through. A little stranger cell. We call red blood cell, but this is not cell. Actually, this is not cell. So this is different. See? White cells can catch invaders and kill. They also they produce special material, interferon, interleukin. They stimulate other activity of white blood cells, also can make fever. Interleukin 1 is known as fever causing substance. Our body needs fever. Once bacteria, viruses invade, what fever does? To inhibit microbe activity and multiply, growth. And the fever is high, it can kill microbes. For our body also not so strong for fever. But usually, bacteria, virus are more weak for high fever. So temperature goes up more than 104 or more, then almost they die. So I don't know you heard about this. But doctors once tried heat remedy, make body hot, mainly used for syphilis. Syphilis was so difficult disease and widespread all over the world so badly. Probably I don't need to explain syphilis, you know. But syphilis is a little also strange. Some people, without doing any treatment, recovered. And once recovered, they get immunity. And the whole life never get again syphilis. That's good. See? Medical world understood more and more. They found if syphilis patient get high fever disease, then high fever killed all bacteria. Then artificially heat up body, then what happened? Seems good. So some doctors tried. Put in patient body to hot tank. But this is a little difficult. If body temperature goes up high 103.4, patient feels so uncomfortable. But to kill bacteria completely, heat more. If not, inside did not become hot. Another technique. For example, put in malaria bacteria to syphilis patient. This worked very good. I forgot the name, but American University Hospital has much record of this treatment for examination, for trial. Many patients cured. But still that time, malaria was also a difficult disease to cure. So syphilis was cured and got malaria. So same as trading disease. Which is better, which is worse, a little hard to say. But now antibiotics discovered, both can cure, so this treatment became needless. But this is a good example. Another example is measles. Probably modern people get vaccination, so don't know about this disease. But just almost attack children, for adult body has immunity. Once get this disease, whole life almost sure, never get again. So now artificially put in virus to children's body and make weak disease, slight symptom, also can get immunity. Sound good?
No.
But this also, we know. I was born before vaccination developed. So, fever is important. If make cold by ice, iceberg, ice pillow, or aspirin, etc., this is dangerous. High fever comes out, but just let it run. This was not lethal or a fatal disease. But if give such treatment, probably another virus or bacteria attack. Maybe pneumonia or such kind. Then disease complicated and no cure, died. So always if children get disease, they heat up room or bed and just keep warm within 2-3 days or 1 week. All disease gone. So this is not so difficult. Just naturally recover. Don't need special treatment.
What about,
me?
Sorry?
Yeah, any question?
What about when your temperature goes too high, is that dangerous?
So, yeah, that's right. If temperature goes up more than 106, then come to dangerous states. For high temperature, can cook our brain. You know how to make half boiled egg. Probably 110 degree, about 18 hours boil. 110 degree, that's not hot. Someone can take a hot bath, 110. And this temperature, egg keep 18 hours, then becomes a perfect half-boiled egg. Probably this will be best. But if our body temperature goes up to 110, then almost hopeless. Brain damage is too bad. So, in such case, we need to protect. Also, I can tell you why someone make such high temperature, 108. Maybe 108 is maximum, maybe 109, but this is seldom. Probably too many egg and chicken or poultry. Bird's body temperature is high. 108, 110 is normal. Very strange. Hot blood animal. Our body is about 98 something. Chicken, bird temperature 108, 110. Their body is made by high octane fuel, like a jet engine, to fly in the sky. They are most active animal. They can travel all world by themselves. So, body temperature always high. And if we eat also, probably make such high temperature. Look at hospital food. Every day chicken and eggs. I don't know the reason why they serve so much. Then, many pneumonia patients even developed antibiotics, never recovered. Like Mrs. Truman, 1 month more continuous high fever. One side serving chicken and eggs. One side trying to take down fever. So, then we can understand why we have such high fever. Then also, once, unfortunately, anybody get, then how to treat. I think already someone learned, but best treatment is CARP, live carp. Carp blood. Cut this area of carp. About 1 foot size carp. Can you find? Still alive. Okay. Take out from water and hit around this area. Then hold the tail and hang up. Water, blood drips. Receive in small cup and give about two tablespoons or what? How much is one sake cup? Maybe 2 tablespoons. That's good enough. And give patient. Within 10 minutes, body temperature start to fall down. And this treatment never have such bad reaction like aspirin or other chemical drugs. Probably this has healing power also.
You were saying earlier that when certain animals are killed, that sometimes the people get sick because of that. Mm-hmm. And you're reminding me about biblical teaching that was saying, sacrifice the animal, the blood will cleanse for the indiscreet.
Yeah, probably. Of
so
course, I don't feel good to kill a calf, but for human life, inevitable. So maybe I am teaching wrong thing, but someone you need. If not, once happen, difficult. Of course, we have another treatment. That's tofu plaster. This is easy, so good to remember. Tofu plaster. You know tofu, of course. Now, in United States, tofu is very common. Just squeeze out water and apply forehead, back head, and the thumb on the chest. If need, also upper part of back. This here we have lung, so here, and the back neck, and the forehead. Very easy, very simple, and cheap. They also take down fever and has healing power. That's strange. Of course, I cannot prove by modern scientific technique. But try actually, not only high fever, any kind of brain damage, brain tumor, brain cancer, good for everything, such kind of brain trouble. Just brain at all, forehead and back head, or some part. Sometimes need to shave hair, but the hair comes back, so that's okay. See? Please check always body temperature. If go down too much, 98.6 or something should be normal. So If fever come down to about 100, they already remove all plaster or all kind of treatment, don't need. Not dangerous. If temperature go down too low, that's terrible. Very difficult to make higher. The lower temperature, more uncomfortable. Whole body feel cold. So that need to take care. The fever is not terrible. Another problem. Now, aspirin was understood poison. Probably United States prohibit to sell over-the-counter. Soon becomes a prescription drug. Many troubles came out. One kind of Leigh syndrome. This is almost a children's disease. But before, almost 100% fetal. Almost flu. Once flu spread, of course, many people take aspirin. Some people started this disease, brain damage. And no cure. Now, a little understood, so more people can recover, but still dangerous disease. Most dangerous, that within 1 year old newborn babies. But not only infant, also young children. Even 15 years old boy sometimes died. Then we have another problem by vaccination. Vaccine was thought always effective for whole life, almost permanent. Once we get smallpox vaccine, we never get. Once we get measles vaccine, we never get. But now, this is not right. Something wrong. This example is subacute sclerosing pan-encephalopathy. A little difficult name. This is also 100% lethal. No cure. Brain damage. Very strange. Almost exclusively about 15 years old boy. Not girls. Not younger or not older, almost around this age. A little strange. Virus was discovered. What caused this disease? See? This is measles virus. That's terrible. Everybody thought, whole life we are safe from measles, but not true. Some people get. Why such thing happen? Of course, medical world cannot understand. So, probably later or tomorrow, we can understand more food. Also, this is clear. We? At all. Any question? Yeah.
Do I think the prisoners did not get the Black Plague?
Black Plague, yes.
The prisoners did not get it.
Not yet finished?
No, why did the prisoners not get it? Why do you think?
Isolated. At all. Rats cannot invade to prison. Probably at all, surrounded by fence or stone wall. Also, stone wall houses were safer, and wooden house was more dangerous. See, that time, Pope Clement VI lived in Avignon. See, midsummer, during Black Death is most prevalent. See, he sit down on the big center of big hall, and made fire always his front and back. And he always prayed to God, please cure this disease or something, I don't know. Prayed. And the food, everything carried by servant, he just sit. Continuously made fire. Very strange protection. Who invented this also not known. But something reasonable. If always making fire, then rats freeze, cannot approach. So.
The grave robbers during the Black Death protected themselves with garlic and vinegar.
Uh-huh.
And none of them got sick.
Yeah, garlic is good, probably, surely. This is good food for many kind of disease. Also, if I talk about food, then already that time, Guido Chauliac. This is an excellent doctor, probably. He was a personal physician of Pope Clement VI. he wrote about food. This is also very interesting. I did not explain why Poland people were safe, but he wrote, don't eat old cattle's meat. Don't eat fat animals' meat. Small fish from river, that's okay. Good to eat spices like clove, pepper, or such kind of spices. Small amount put in the soup or something, that's good. Drink tiny amount of wine many times a day. This is also good. Fat people don't take sun bath. And don't use olive oil for cooking. Eat dinner before 1 hour of sunset. And go to bed early and get up at the time of sunrise. Don't go out midnight. Don't eat midnight. He wrote very clearly, very kind. See, everything is reasonable. Now, many historians or doctors' understanding, before plague, famine, starvation, very bad, and malnutrition made this plague, many plagues. But I found out this is completely wrong. Malnutrition never makes such kind of plagues. Always overnourished people. Of course, if we say unbalanced food to malnutrition, one kind of malnutrition. But exactly say malnutrition means absolutely short, some kind of nutrition, not excess. Now, in United States or Canada, many people eat so much rich food and making some kind of malnutrition. But this is coming from excess, not from shortage. So this is also important subject to discuss. So yeah. Yes.
Tofu plaster, does it raise fever or lower it?
Black widow death?
No. Huh? Tofu plaster, does it lower or raise fever?
Lower. Lower, but healing has, it has healing power. So no bad reaction. Absolutely safe.
Second question.
Yes.
What raises fever?
Huh? What? Raises a fever.
Lay syndrome.
No. What makes it go higher? What makes a fever go up? What makes it go up?
Interferon. Probably other substances also work, but this is important. Once bacteria virus attack our body cells, the white cells find out, they react. Make interferon, interleukin-1. interleukin 1 going to bloodstream and soon come to brain. See? We have a heat controlling center. This react and make high fever. Yes.
No, sorry, my question was different. What can I take to produce fever?
Any technique to rise up body temperature?
Yes.
Artificially, this is difficult. So, I talk to doctor's examination. To malaria, bacteria, or typhoid, or such kind of fever disease. For example, if we take sauna bath, the surface can go up very high. But to heat inside the organ, that's difficult.
Herbs?
Will ginger help?
Yeah. Pardon?
Can you take ginger, that sort of thing?
Pardon?
Can you take ginger inside?
Would ginger work?
Ah, ginger.
Yeah.
Ah, spices. Hmm. Ato, garlic. Or ginger, or clove, pepper, spices. Almost this kind of food has special enzyme to dissolve animal protein. So, usually, if you eat meat, put on spice on the meat, I think, and eat. That's enzyme help, digestion and utilization. Also take off some poison. So, if you eat meat, then probably that's need. Okay.
Would that satisfy raising the body temperature to fight disease?
Artificially rise up temperature, this is difficult.
So it can't be done then?
Also, usually don't need. The question is about our body temperature. In the past, everybody thought we have normal temperature. But now, new research understood. No normal temperature. What is normal? Just we can say about average. Average also not accurate, so about. For our body temperature always up and down, never stay same. In the morning and evening, already about 1 or 2 degrees higher or lower. Usually morning is lower, and afternoon is higher. And if we sleep, the temperature goes down, also 1 or 2 degrees, only slight. We can sleep better, we can take rest better, and don't use much energy. So, this is important. And once wake up and get up, start body temperature goes up and becomes, how I can say, not normal temperature, what is it? Usually say they go back to normal temperature. And go to work or more activity, temperature is higher. For example, you know, many athletes always have warming up exercise. Before start a race or game, they warm up their body. What do they do? By warming up, our muscles, our organs works much better for human body enzymes. Enzymes produced by body cells. If we move, the body cell makes more heat. This is easy, but this slight. Probably goes up about 100. Maybe inside organ 101. See? Our muscle move more smoothly. And inside organs, heart, lungs, everything work more actively. So this is good for athletes. But of course, use much fuel, calorie, or carbohydrate, whatever we can say. Yeah.
Does the virus live? Is it alive?
Still alive. 101, that cannot kill, probably.
But the virus is a living organism?
Yeah. Yeah, this new understanding, virus is a living organism, for they have gene or DNA or RNA, but genes. This carry life and hereditary. So if someone has genes, they considered living. Virus has. So, about this temperature, we can rise up our body temperature and activate our body muscles. But still cannot kill bacteria, virus. And, one more, exhaust quickly, lose much energy for burning. So also should be replaced. Probably you know, during high fever, even 1 pound, every day we can lose weight. If we have high fever, not only carbohydrate, even protein break down and use fuel. So patient lose weight quickly. But still not bad to kill bacteria, virus, 104, 105, still okay.
What about parasites?
not about parasite. Okay. Usually, any kind of living organism depend completely to some other organism. Okay. This we call parasite. For human disease, for example, worms, sometimes living in our intestine, also invade to other organs or some place. This very common parasite. But exactly say, many kind of parasites. If you say more, on this world, almost everything are parasites. For example, human and animals. All animals eat plants. So we are parasites on plants. They, plants take nutrition from us always. So this is also one kind of parasite for us. The bacteria or virus, whatever, if invade to our body or animal body and take nutrition, this is also one kind of parasite. But our world, in the beginning I talked, always battlefield, but also same time, helping each other for plants provide nutrition for human and animals. Also animals supporting plants growing. For example, we make a lot of carbon dioxide. Plants take carbon dioxide and make carbohydrate, fat, protein, many kind of nutrition, and excrete oxygen. And this oxygen we take. So, also same time, we are helping each other always. Okay.
If internally people have parasite and it becomes a problem, there are too many for the body to handle, what is the process for getting rid of them to make them not have what they need? They
so, yeah, so all kind of bacteria, virus, or parasites, this is our problem. Now I am talking how completely protect our body from such kind of parasites. And stay perfectly healthy. So, always I talk. Problem is food related. So, already a couple of examples I talked. Ate rodent and started black death and green monkey or sheep, diseased sheep had the AIDS virus. More and more many examples. So maybe tomorrow I can talk such kind of diseases. But right now, still, I'm talking about human body protection. So, yeah.
Do you know anybody that has healed AIDS?
Cured AIDS?
Yeah.
Not yet. Much improvement, but not yet I had a perfect cure for almost nobody understand how related with food. How is and food related?
How are they related then?
Hmm?
How are they related?
What kind of relation with food? So, how protect our body? So, in California, at Los Altos, one famous doctor, Robert Cathcart, he gave large doses of vitamin C for Kaposi sarcoma patient. And he reported many patients recovered about 80%. But he cannot complete another 20%. In Boston and New York, many macrobiotic people trying to cure AIDS seems much improved, but not yet I heard anybody recovered completely. And now Japanese doctors reported herbal teas, traditional oriental herbal teas, ginseng herb tea, and small saikoto. This is effective to cure AIDS. Ginseng herb tea. マイナーサイコト。おスモール。マッチインプルーメント。But not yet safe, perfect recovery. We have to wait.
Is anybody immune to it?AIDS, such as
immunity?
Yeah,
probably. Probably many people strong enough for AIDS virus itself not so powerful, not so strong. So they are so slow. I talked Black Death. Within 2 days, some people died. Almost 2 weeks.But AIDS is said from 8 months to 10 years incubation period. And after this incubation period, the symptoms come out. Now a little quick. Within 2-3 years, average about 2 years, almost everybody dying.And started microbiotics 4 or 5 years, still living. Seems okay. But not yet proved to be cured. Why microbiotic people cannot cure AIDS? Probably not enough salt.In Canada, I don't know, but now in United States, so many people, also doctors, scientists, has fear for salt. Also, the quality of salt not so good. Now, commercial sea salt and salt is too pure. 99.9% sodium chloride. Some salt, iodine, calcium, and dextrose mixed. But still not enough. One come from poor quality. One come from shortage. Especially chlorine or chloride, chlorine shortage. This is big. If we eat meat, then probably we can get enough sodium. But chlorine is missing, very low. Chlorine is important to kill bacteria, virus, probably you know. Your water is treated by chlorine, drinking water.
Is that chlorine?
Chlorine, yeah. Chlorine. Yeah. It's a strong poison. But the human body need. If we eat salt, then sodium and chlorine combined completely, perfectly, so no poison. Our body can separate this two strong poisons and make hydrochloric acid, whatever we need. Our body is a magician. What is that?
Yeah, does this is her question pertains to the male, to men.
Men.
Yeah. Okay. Does excessive sexual activity weaken the immune system?
Okay. maybe overactive sex related. But more fundamental problem is why such strong excess sexual appetite, sexual activity. Probably clearly indicate eat meat, animal food. Our food is only two kind. If we can classify, what else? Plants or animals? I talked. Always we eat living organism. Other substance we eat. That's water and salt and some other. Only a little bit. Compared to this main food, almost nothing. Then, eat animal or eat plant, how different? Then, man like to eat meat. Woman like to eat sugar. This is two typical food. One is animal food, one is plant food. Right? See? If we discuss AIDS problem, see? S- so many countries, now about 140 countries on this world reported is some. So it is said global epidemic. Maybe true, but maybe not. Incidence of AIDS is very uneven. Probably worst area, tropical Africa. But unfortunately, they don't report so many. Medical examination is not sure. Also, they are so poor. Cannot get examination or treatment. So, just guessing. Clearly examined and reported that United States. Now about 45,000 patients recently reported. This is highest. Okay. Next, European urban area of Brazil, Argentina, New Zealand, Australia, and Haiti, and some Caribbean. This is next. Okay. We can see clearly meat-eating people get more AIDS. Okay? Highest consumption of meat, New Zealand, Argentina, Switzerland, and the United States. Also urban area of Brazil. So, this country has more often Kaposi's sarcoma. It's said one kind of cancer. But probably this is not cancer.
Whatever medical research say, a little strange.
Before, cancer was not contagious. Not an infection. But now AIDS is said, AIDS is an infection. Also AIDS is contagious. And this is one kind of cancer. Maybe not right. Cancer is much more difficult disease. But anyway, please pay attention. Kaposi's sarcoma usually start from legs or foot. Tumor or cancer or whatever, growth started usually from foot or legs. Of course, sometimes from anus or mouth or other part, but this is rare. As an example, gout. You know gout. Middle-aged people called royal disease. Only rich people get. Now gout is so common, about 200 million patients in United States. So many royal families. Also start from foot. Another trouble is gangrene. usually start from toe of foot. Or many diabetes infection, diabetes also start from downside of toe. This is very clear in medical record. But the doctor's opinion, the reason is unknown. For me, that's strange. Seems very clear. Okay? And this is very interesting. If we eat meat, nutrition, energy, toxins, everything tend to go down more than go up. Okay? So, for lower body activity, this is good. To make infant, young children, make stronger legs or longer, bigger legs, meat is better. Nutrition goes down more. But if we eat too much, also toxic material, waste product, also tend to go down. Of course, cannot divide completely. Blood is one. Always circulating whole body, so mixed up, especially in the heart, all correct, mixed and push. But still, heavy materials goes down more than up, and lighter materials goes up more than down. What is lighter material? Then, clearly, plants. Plants grow up always this way. Okay? Here almost never grow. For example, children make sign. Small children hit this side here, nail. Then, 5 years later, check this, then his body grow up from here to here, much lower. This almost never move. Plants do not grow this way. Just grow more and more to top. And for what grow on the top? That's flower. Fruit. This energy goes up, or nutrition goes up. So come to here. And inside of flower we have honey. This is best nutrition for our brain and most terrible poison for our brain. A little strange. Good nutrition can turn to poison. So, please check. If you have anybody brain tumor, brain cancer, they love to eat honey. This is strongest. Next of honey is sugar, refined sugar. This also goes up. And many people eat a lot. So, make brain damage, brain weaker. This is plant where human body. Human body grow this way. Newborn baby, big head, and small body, and very short legs. Grow this way only a little bit. They grow this way many times. So this short leg body and the big head go this way very small, go this way a lot. Clearly indicate animal nutrition, animal energy tend to go down. Hey, now problem is hey, one typical kind of AIDS is Kaposi sarcoma. This is excess meat. Hey, another more prevalent form of AIDS is pneumonia and tuberculosis. This is the upper part of body.